Okay. Fellow Toastmasters and no guest, I have good news and bad news. First, the bad news. Alzheimer's disease may soon outpace heart disease. Currently, there's no known cure. There's a good chance everyone here knows of someone who's affected by this condition of the brain wasting away. This is personal for me. My father and some of my friends have Alzheimer's. Now, for the good news. I'm going to share fun ways we can reduce our risk of getting this dreadful disease. A study published in the New England Journal of Medicine reported there are leisure activities we can do to help prevent Alzheimer's and dementia. To name a few, reading, playing board games, and dancing. Need my other shoes. There's more good news. An article in Getting Healthier addresses how creative thinking helps improve memory and brain function. The article addresses how creative thinking helps improve our skills, and it lists activities that apply creative thinking. Raise your hand if one of these activities appeals to you, even if you don't know how to do it yet. Ballroom dancing, crossword puzzles, Sudoku, reading, learning a foreign language, cooking, drumming, learning a new skill. If you're not sure which new skill to learn, I highly recommend juggling. According to Nature magazine, juggling increases gray matter. I'm still learning. My left hand is a loose cannon. The tosses are wild. Get ready to duck! There are so many variations to juggling, you'll never run out of new skills to learn. Try standing on one foot. Two beanbags with one hand. Move on to throwing more difficult objects. No, not chainsaws, but rubber chickens would be a kick. Juggling and all those activities apply creative thinking and reduce our risk of dementia. Say what? You mean we can ward off the heartbreaking, brain-erasing disease by participating in fun, stress-relieving activities? Yep. Doesn't that make you want to get up and do a happy dance? Da, 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 da. Here's a breakdown on the study. Sports activities such as swimming and bicycling reduce the risk of dementia by 0%. That may surprise you. However, keep in mind, this particular study focused only on the brain and not on the benefits of cardio workouts. Reading reduced the risk by 35%. Doing crossword puzzles 4 days a week reduced the risk by 47%. Dancing frequently reduced the risk of dementia by 76%. Specifically, ballroom dancing, such as the foxtrot, waltz, tango, swing, and Latin. Ballroom dancing applies various brain functions working together in sync. For instance, music, thought, emotions, movement, and physical touching of your dance partner. Ballroom dancing applies all of those brain functions and calls for rapid-fire responses which create new neural pathways. It's as if the brain is performing mental gymnastics. I have more good news. There's no talent required. Regardless of having two left feet, no sense of rhythm, and no experience dancing, our brains still improve. We reap the benefits of learning new skills. Stimulating the brain while learning new skills is key, especially skills which call for split-second decisions. There's even more good news. In case you're unable to dance, other experts are studying the benefits of singing to fight dementia. What a nice variety of activities to choose from to reduce our risk of Alzheimer's and dementia. You'll never get bored if you mix it up. Remember, talent is not a prerequisite to learning new skills, and you don't have to master your new skills to improve your brain. A new skill can be a new sport, a new hobby, a new game, anything you haven't learned yet, or variations of the skills you already know. Let's practice our new skills as often as possible. I'm going to dance with my father every chance I can get. What do you say we get out there and dance our hearts out, learn some new skills, and keep our brains young?